We at a time when we find ourselves at a loss as to how we should go forward in this crossroad. We have what we call sanskars, and the Vedic texts say that when we reach a crossroad in life, then we need to have a map that will take us to our destination. And right now, that destination is the well-being, the health of ourselves as individuals, family, our communities, our country, and the world at large. While the doctors, the various scientists, the medical fraternity are trying their level best, while governments are doing the utmost they can, we can offer a simple prayer. And in this instance, the yajna, the Havan or Agnihotra, brings us in tune with nature again.
So as now governments have put closures and lockdowns and we have to be confined to our homes, what is this indirectly telling us? It's indirectly telling us it's time to go within and introspect who we really are and what our responsibilities are in this earth. We have the tools, our body has the tools to regenerate itself, to remove all these diseases. Paramatma, our creator, in that divine wisdom, has given us the tools in nature, the plants, the herbs, to be able to partake and assist the body in healing itself. This is the time when we introspect and we go back to our roots through meditation, through pranayama, to performing yajna, Agnihotra. We are able to allow the body to start healing itself. The answer is within. The answer is in the scripture that we have, the Vedas. The mantras that we are performing are Vedic mantras. The ingredients for the samagri which we put in, which I'll explain in a moment. Where do those ingredients come from? Explained in the Vedas. The tools are there.
The yajna has elements of purification, of understanding the laws of creation and where we fit in, about offerings that we make, and the yajna being a sacrifice where others benefit from what we do. The fragrance is supposed to go out, and according to the mantras, from the stream of ghee and samagri, it becomes shatadhara, 100 streams, and then sahasradhara, 1,000 streams. And that means the vapor through that agni goes into the environment and purifies the environment. We believe that in many ways we have violated the laws of nature. We have transgressed and brought along in that process a lot of harm to ourselves, which we are aware of.
This is exactly what happens when we go out of synchronization with nature. As human beings, we are born from the earth, we are born from the skies. Every cell of our body emanates what's happening in this entire solar system. We are not separate from it. We are not individual from it. We as mankind, sadly, over the years, have taken this role of being in charge and superior to everything, as if everything exists because we exist. And as a result, we have destroyed the atmosphere. We are currently destroying it. The environment is suffering as a result of our actions. Whether it's cutting down the trees, whether it's killing the animals, whether it's by our actions and killing each other, whether it's the litter and the pollution that's destroying everything around us. So what happens is the whole of the natural cycle is out of balance. But this is the beauty of nature. It can either heal itself or it will destroy itself to save the other energies. It depends on how the situation is.
The yajna is described in English as a ritual. The word ritual comes from the Sanskrit word ritu, means seasons. So the yajna as a ritual, embodies and encapsulates this message of the cycle of life, and all of creation goes through that process. They are the elements and the laws of nature that we'll have to live in sync with. It starts off with the sipping of water. And today, even when we have the virus, we are saying water is crucial. Then we touch the different limbs of our body and we ask that we be blessed with a healthy body and that we use our organs to keep that which is wholesome and allow that which is impure to be washed away. The Samagri stands as a symbol of offering, of sacrifice. We offer, and whatever we offer is transformed by the fire into a beautiful fragrance, and we say, Iddam na mama, or Iddam na mama, this is not mine. Nothing is mine, and everything that comes to us from the elements and nature, and one day will certainly resolve again into that nature.
There are two basic forms of energy that are very powerful and have transformative effects: sound energy and heat energy. Now, I find when the Vedas first came to the dawn of mankind, they came in the form of sound. They came in the form of meditation. Only in the later years were they put down into script. The recitation, proper recitation and chanting of Vedic mantras, built on a specific vibrational sequence, helps transform the energies within the body and in the environment around us to heal the body, to settle the mind, and to clear the environment around us. So physically, spiritually, and mentally, all forms are covered by Vedic mantras alone. Then we come to the physical aspects of heat. Chemically and scientifically, what is happening is we are putting natural herbal ingredients into that fire, which then through the science of combustion releases chemicals and chemical compositions and gases that actually transform and kill bacteria, radiation, viral infections, and anything that's inconducive to the natural balance between physical beings and the earth and the environment.
So, at a time like this, I think the moment demands that we sit, and in the lockdown that is taking place in several countries, we are once again forced to go back to our families, to our values, and that then creates a sense of oneness with nature. And we all know that this disease that we have presently has resulted because of the manner in which we've been carrying ourselves and some of the ways in which we have been eating and conducting ourselves that has brought harm to ourselves and the environment.
Now, specifically when it comes to, let's say, viruses and the coronavirus such as this, we know it's vitally important that now that we have the tools of both sound and heat energy, which are proven, scientifically proven, to actually create a positive atmosphere around us, both in the sense of destroying negative elements, destroying viruses and destroying bacteria through what is released. Internally, the chants and the vibration and the inhalation of the scent from these herbs actually has an impact to destroy the viruses and bacteria within. Now, there was a doctor in the East who actually did an experiment with water. And when certain recitations are made, the molecule structures actually change. And if that can happen to water, 70% of our body is water. The water vapors in the environment, and that's just water alone. What about the air that we breathe? What about the skin cells? Each one of these are transformed positively for the human being, for the animals, and for the environment around us.
Every time we chant a mantra, we begin by chanting Om. And in the Gayatri Mantra, it says, Om Bhur Bhuvah Swaha. The message of the Vedas and of Indian thought. Because it says that Om is inherent or pervades in Bhu. Bhu is Bhumi or earth. In every grain of sand, every drop of water, the little herbs, the trees, the bird, the beast, and in you and me, Om reverberates.
Sanskrit is not just a language with a meaning. It's a vibration designed to do something specific based on what the mantra is trying to explain to you. In the case of Agnihotra mantras, or certain Havan mantras, as we recite it, it works either with the health of the eye, with the health of the heart, with the health of the body, with the health of the environment. So likewise, pronunciation is so vital and important, because if we mispronounce, we could be leading that vibration to make another effect. So in this case, first prize would be to pronounce correctly and to recite the mantra yourself. But if you can't do that, then the second best, still effective, is listening it through your phone, through a radio, because having somebody else recite it still has a powerful effect to the environment around us and to the body if we sit, listen, and give our attention to it.
Everything has a pattern, has a law, and a way by which it is governed. When we light the yajna, it is again stated in the mantras that yajna is that agni, and agni really is not just fire, but the essence of energy. The samagri has to have specific ingredients so that they in turn, through the process of combustion, help to keep this vayumandal or this dome, this atmosphere, as pure as we can make it as human beings.
So we have ingredients such as jatamasi, such as the ashwagandha root, and there are about 120 different herbs, specific herbs, which when mixed together for the Agnihotra, release certain chemical compounds that target and destroy viruses in the air. But it works also hand in hand, and more powerfully so, with specific mantras that contain the names of these herbs and work together like a catalyst. Think of an opera singer. When an opera singer sings at a specific peak, it can actually shatter glass. Likewise, we're using the power of sound through the mantras, which use these specific, call it 100 and some odd herbs, that when the chemical reaction is released together with the sound, it works hand in hand to actually shattering the viruses, combing them and destroying them. Thereafter, the ash, when we consume the ash has an inner healing and inner medicinal effect for the body as well. So we have the smoke, we have the sound vibration, and the physical ash that can be taken with water to have a medicinal effect. If you take that same ash and put it and water it with your plants, look at the effect and strength and health of your plants.
All these elements, they do not judge. The sun does not choose to shine over one and not over the other. So it is non-judgmental in its giving. And very important, neither the rivers, nor the trees, nor the breezes ever stop to ask, what is there in it for me, or what have you done for me?
Agnihotra, performed ideally at sunset or sunrise, and let me just quickly explain why sunset or sunrise. It is at the point of sunset and sunrise that trees and plants absorb the most carbon dioxide. So any carbon dioxide that is released from the Agnihotra is absorbed with maximum effect from the plants, therefore maximum amount of oxygen is given. Now when it's performed at home, remember, as I said, one of the great effects is removal of radiation, whether it's radiation from your phones, from the microwaves, from the television. So constant and regular and daily performance twice a day of Agnihotra at home will have such an amazing effect. We've heard of Bhopal, what happened when there was the nuclear explosion at Bhopal. The families that did Havan in their homes were actually not affected by what was released at that catastrophe.
So these are the basic lessons, and it is almost as though nature is a prophet that is bringing us the message. And that message holds true for every human being. It is there every day for us to see, but unfortunately, we really just don't stop to listen, to hear what the message of nature is. And therefore, we say the message of the Vedas is eternal. The message is an eternal one.
Havan, Yajya or Agnihotra is a simple prayer that forms the core of all our ceremonies, kathas, and major religious observances. This recording aims to bring the Havan right into your home in its simplest form. The Havan is a communal prayer where the entire family, servants included, participate. The mantras ask for the well-being of the family. The mantras also express gratitude for what we have been blessed with. The offering of samagri is a gesture of appreciation. The mantras remind us that whatever we possess, our human body and material belongings, are not ours. Idam namama or idan namama means this is not mine. We need material belongings to make our lives comfortable, but we must not become attached to them. Agni, fire, is the essence of life. We revere Agni, for without it, there can be no creation. The sun, heat, and energy are manifestations of Agni. We pay homage to the plants, the earth, sun, wind, fire, and water, and pledge that we will not violate the laws of nature. We pray that the bird, beast, and all other creatures also prosper. We ask that we be blessed with pure, noble thoughts, a sense of charity, sweet speech, and the spontaneous urge to share what we have for the common good of all. The husband and wife sit with each other at the Havan. The Yajna or Havan embodies the aspirations, wholesome morals and values that we as families cherish. What you will need to perform a simple Havan: a small, simple Havan kun, a handful of dry mango or any other suitable wood, a piece of camphor, 100 grams of samagri, a little ghee, about 5 tablespoons, any sweet offering of fruit, an apple or banana or any other seasonal fruit. This is not a must. A container with water and a spoon. And do remember that as far as possible, you must do the Havan in your home. Keep it simple. Make it a family prayer. Enjoy doing it. Observe cleanliness. Abstinence is important as an act of discipline. Prayer is meant to keep us closer to spirituality. Vegetarianism demonstrates our compassion for all living beings. Avoid eating meat, at least when you pray. To begin the Havan, we'll chant Om 3 times. Let us chant Om.
Oh.
Shretam Swaha. We take water in our left palm, and with the middle fingers of the right palm, we touch the different parts of our body, as indicated in your books. Om Vam Vasyestu. Om Nasurme Pranostu. Om Aknurve Chakshurastu. Om Karnayurve Shrotramastu. Namastu. With this mantra, we place the camphor in the spoon and set it alight.
Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha.
And after this mantra, we place it amidst the wood.
Om Bhurbhuvah Svaridhyoriva Bhumna Prithviva Varimna Tasyaste Prithvi Devayajani Prishte Agnim Annadam Annadhyā Yadadhe.
And now adjust the pieces of wood if necessary.
Om Udbudhya Svagni Prati Jagrihi Tvam Mishta Purte Sansrije Thamayancha Asmin Sadhaste Adhyuttarasmin Vishve Deva Yajmanascha Siddhata.
With each of these mantras, place a samidha into the yajna after swaha.
Om ayanta idma atma jata vedaste nedyasva vardasva chedha vardaya chasma prajaya pashuvir brahma varchasenana Dhyena Samedhaya Swaha Idam Agnaye Jata Vedase Idannamama. Om Samedha Agnim Duvasyata Hritair Bodhayata Titim Asmin Havyajyotana. Samidhaya Shochishe Gritam Divram Juhotana Agnaye Jatvedase Swaha Idam Agnaye Jatvedase Idannamama. Om Tanva Samidhir Angiro Gritena Vardhaya Brihacho Chaya Vishya Swaha Idam Magnaye Angirase Idannamama.
With this mantra chanted 5 times, an offering of a drop or two of ghee each time after swaha.
Om Ayanta Yadma Atma Jata Vedaste Nedyasva vardhasvachedha vardhaya chasman prajaya pashyavar brahma varchasenana dena same dhayasvaha idam magnaye jatvedase idannamama om ayanta yatma atma jatvedase vardhasvachedhavardhaya chasman prachaya pashyavarbrahma varchasenana dena same dhayasvaha idam magnaye jatvedase idannamama om ayanta yatma atma jātare-dastene-dhyasva-vardasva-cetha-vardhaya chāsmān-prajaya-paśyo-virbrahma-vartya-senāna-dhena-same-dhaya-svāha idam-magnaye-jātare-dase-idannamamā Om ayanta yatma atma jātare-dastene-dhyasva vardasva-cetha-vardhaya chāsmān-prajaya paśyo-virbrahma-vartya-senāna-dhena-same-dhaya-svāha idam magnaye jātare-dase idannamama om ayanta yatma atma jātare-dastene-dhyasva vardasva-cetha-vardhaya chāsmān-prajaya paśyo-virbrahma-vartya-senāna-dhena-same-dhaya-svāha idam magnaye jātare-dase idannamama
jal sinchan, the sprinkling of water around the fire in the directions as indicated in the Havan booklet.
Om aditenu manyasva Om anumate anumanyasva Om sarasvati anumanyasva Om deva savitah prasuvayajyam bhagaya divyo gandharva ketapu ketannah punatu vachaspatir vachannasvadatu
with swaha a drop or two of ghee into the fire as indicated in your booklet.
Om agnaye swaha idam agnaye idannamama Om somaya swaha idam somaya idannamama Om prajapataye swaha idam prajapataye idannamama Om indraya swaha idam indraya idannamama
And now with these mantras we offer ghee and samagri each time after chanting swaha
Om Suryo Jyotir Jyotir Surya Swaha. Om Suryo Varcho Jyotir Varchah Swaha. Om Jyotis Surya Suryo Jyotis Swaha. Om Sajyo Devena Savitra Sajyo Ushasendra Vartya Jushana Suryo Vetu Swaha. Again, with ghee and samagri, after Swaha, Om Agnir Jyotir Jyotir Agni Swaha. Om Agnir Varcho Jyotir Varcha Swaha. Jushano Agnir Vetu Swaha. Once again, ghee and samagri each time after Swaha. Om Bhuragnaye Pranaya Swaha. Idam Agnaye Pranaya Idannamama. Om Bhuvarvaya Veyapanaya Swaha. Idam Vaya Veyapanaya Idannamama. Om Swaradityaya Vyanaya Swaha. Idam Madityaya Vyanaya Idannamama. Om Bhurbhuva Swarani Vaya Vaidityevya Pranapana Vyanevya Swaha. Idam Agni Vaya Vaidityevya Pranapana Vyanevya Idannamama. Om Apo Jyotirasu Amritam Brahma Bhurbhuva Swaro Swaha. Om Yam Medham Devagana Pitarascho Pasati Dayama Madhya Medhaya Asuva Swaha. Om Agni Naya Subhata Raya Yasman Vishwani Deva Vayunani Vidvan Yuyodhi Yasmat Jurana Meno Bhuishtante Nama Uptim Vidhema Swaha. The Purnahuti or final offerings, again ghee and samagri after Swaha, thus. Om Sarvam Vai Purnam Swaha. Om Sarvam Vai Purnam Swaha. Om Sarvam Vai Purnam Swaha. Om Jai 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 Shri Swami Jai Jai. Shanti.
Namaste, namaste.